I go in front.
Okay, good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you, everybody?
Good.
Tired.
Hungry.
Sleepy.
Later we have a food. After the tea break, you can have it. We have a very nice food.
Okay.
Sleeping during my class, I believe you won't sleep. There will be a lot of funny things, there will be a lot of interesting things, and a lot of things to learn.
Okay. I trust you.
Thank you. Okay. Today we have our occupational first aid course. I am the facilitator for today. Okay. And our schedule is today. Okay. We will go through all this in morning session. So, first thing, we will have introduction. I will know each other. Second thing, we recognize the medical emergency situation is workplace. Okay. And the third one, we will have tea break.
Yes,
which is, as you
appreciate.
You know your name, please?
Name is Tom.
Tom, okay. So, Mr. Tom will be having very nice food today.
I would like tea break.
Everybody like to bring that. Okay, we'll be having active appropriate emergency response system, follow emergency action principle, which is CPR. We'll be learn how to do CPR. Okay? Followed by we have principle and technique in applied bandages in case of any bleeding. In the last, we'll be have any question and answer. Okay, let's move on. So first thing, you all know why we are here. Okay? That is very important.
Why?
So
why we are here?
Okay, why? I come back to you. What is first aid? Okay? We must know what is first aid. It is immediate help given to injured person or a person who has suddenly taken ill before medical arrive and ambulance, doctor or other medically qualified personnel. Okay.
Sorry, my English is not good. What does injured
mean? Okay, injured means if somebody get hurt in hand, any of the body part. For example, maybe he doing grinding. Okay, suddenly the slug go in his eye and get injury his eye.
Oh, okay.
So we are here today to basically learn that what if I'm injured, alright, what help you can give to a person before the ambulance comes.
Yes, exactly. So what is our aim for this class? Our aim to preserve life and to prevent condition from worsening and to promote recovery. Okay?
What is PRS?
Okay, preserve life is you have to save his life. The short question, you must save his life. So learning outcome is end of this course you will be able to do bandages to stop bleeding in case of an emergency. Okay, that is our learning outcome. So far clear? Any question? Okay, we move it to next we know each other.
I usually have a lot of questions.
A lot of questions. Okay. So later you share with us. Thank you. So before I move on, let's we know each other. So I have a simple game here, activity. Let's we know what is our body, what we test it. Okay, so I give you this paper to write down each other. We ask him, or you ask him, what is you, what you like. Okay?
So we ask everybody, huh?
Yeah, in that class you ask everybody. Or you can
one person.
At least 4%.
Person.
Okay. So I give you the paper. I have a. Okay, I give you 5 minutes times to write down and you must ask your colleagues and get him signed.
Do you need to move around or you just sit
down? It's okay, you can sit down. And I think it's good to have move around So you can come, remember past it, you can ask him, you can ask him.
Who shelter you want by 6 meter?
I'm
1.8, so not me lah.
You have first aid box at home. That's nice. Okay. So in the principle and technique in applied bandages, we have three techniques over here. First, wear gloves for protection. Apply direct pressure, we stop bleeding. Able to reduce the bleeding.
Okay, no blood pump. If there's no blood pump, any blood? Any kind of glove, there's no cooking on here.
Any kind of gloves?
Any kind of
gloves? No. There must be certified gloves.
No, cooking on here?
Cannot. For general gloves, all this cannot. Cooking gloves cannot.
You cooking, cooking gloves still okay. If no gloves now, use bare hand cannot.
If you say no gloves, that means you didn't check your first aid box. In but order to complete. That's why your gloves is missing. Maybe someone used for other purpose. So you have to check. In order to complete the first aid box, all the item, there must be have at least two gloves. Okay? So I will show you later part. Okay, what are the items to check in the first aid box? So it's easy for us to get an understanding. So far, okay? Clear?
Okay.
Okay, for the eye bandages. Okay? These are the four steps to do the eye bandages. Okay? So the first step, ask the possibility to close both eyes. You have to close both eyes. Second step, place your iPad on the affected eye and ask the possibility to hold should the need require. So use one hand to hold. Then easy for you to grab out. Third step, on the CQ circuit, bring the bandage below the ear and up over the eye and round the bands, head area. Okay? The fourth one, secure the tying down the knob or use the clip. If you have clip, it's good. If you don't have clip, you just tie
down. It's costing it.
If you or cannot tie,
safety pin can.
It's the first safety pin can.
Safety pin can.
Yes, it's the best way.
The
stapler, I won't recommend use stapler. Okay, there is another chances to get into it. Okay, so the good thing is just secure the time, just time. Okay. Later, eye bandages which I will show you later. Okay, later on I will show how to do the eye bandages. But now, right now, just we do little bit exercise. How to make a sling for your arm. Okay, it's a very simple way to do. Only use three steps. Okay? The first step, slip on end of the cloth under your arm and the other over your shoulder. Okay? Second step, bring other end of the sling over your other shoulder. Okay? Third step, tie the end of the sling behind your knee. Okay? Which is, you can see, behind your knee. So far clear? Clear? Have you done before sling arm?
All the time.
All the time? Wow, yeah. Interesting.
The first time I took the course.
Oh, first time you took the course. Okay, this is time for practice. Let's practice how you will do. Okay?
Okay.
In the group, I need 2%, maybe admin do with Mr. What's my name? Tom. Mr. Tom. Okay? Mr. Tom and Bon will do with Eddie. Okay? So I just see how you're doing the
bandages.
Remember one thing.
I know everything.
Remember one thing.
Yeah.
You have 5 minutes time. Okay, this is time.
Never mind, just stay where you are. Like, let me do all the work. I know everything. So you just tell me which hand on your stemming pain.
Yes, and
you open those. Do this only every day. I practice.
Okay.
My dad can read it.
Okay, thank you very much. How about this group? Have you done?
Not really, but this is the best.
Look at us.
I did something wrong.
Something wrong.
Okay, so what is the wrong here?
Oh, it's wrong. Is there anything wrong?
Are we missing something over here? Which step are we missing? Are we missing something over here?
No,
how about home? Are we missing this part?
It's not here already. You never seen. Yeah.
Are we missing this part? Step two.
Oh, different part.
Okay, sit down. Please remove. Please remove.
Oh, I didn't see.
So next we discuss what is the missing part. So we have found there is two missing part. Okay, the first is this. The second part we have missing. Bring the other end of the sleeve over your shoulder. Okay, which is you missing. So let me show you how to do the proper way. Okay. So I need one volunteer.
Okay. I used to think the way I do is right, but
now
maybe.
Okay, first you have the position chairs. Okay. So that is the first step. You hold this position. Just put underneath his arm. The second step, just round and back. Don't too tight, don't too loose. Okay, make it firmly, easily. The number third step, just roll and put it inside.
Why hand must go up?
Okay, he has a good question. Why hand must go up? The reason why his hand is fractured. The more he move, the more it becomes worse. Okay? And the blood will be, his blood will be going down. Okay? So that's the reason his hand must be in the chest. Okay? Clear? Any question? Good, huh? So we learn the better way.
Yeah.
Please sit down. Thank you, babies.
Thank you.
Okay, come discuss. Now I ask you a question. Name one thing that you learned today. How about anything? How would you apply what you have learned in your workplace?
But wait, I have questions. So today we learned about the eye bandage and the sling.
Yes.
Alright. So eye bandage will be the practice.
Okay. For the eye bandage, as I mentioned earlier, we'll be practice later part after the tea break. We learn about eye bandage.
After the tea break.
Yes. So then after born a very nice food, then you do the eye bandage.
Another question. Yeah. If let's say your arm is bleeding and then you fracture as well, right? What do you do? Let's say you fall, you broke the arm, and then you have the gash here and you're bleeding. Right? Do you bandage first or do you do the arm bracing first?
Okay, first thing Tom has mentioned, if the person got bleeding at the same time got fracture, so what you should do? Should we do the sling or should we stop the bleeding? So what do you think, Mr. Eddie?
We should stop bleeding first.
Stop bleeding first, right? Okay, that is the answer. So first thing, we have to stop the bleeding, okay? And second thing, we do the sling. So, how did you apply what you have learned in the workplace, Mr. Eddie?
I think very interesting because just now you say the hand must go up when you are doing the demonstration. Last time I told you, I just climbed, not the.
Can you come here, sorry,
okay.
At least show them
oh.
what you learned today.
So last time when I climbed the sling, or put my hand, because I want the user to. But then now, Dean was telling me you must put the hand slightly up. So because blood flows down by gravity, so if you put it up, you can mitigate the bleeding. So this is very good. And how I apply this in my workplace, I work in the construction site. So accidents do happen, unless we can do about it. So when that happens, I think whatever I learned today, should. In an event, a person fracture his arm, at least I know what to do.
Thank you
very much.
Yes, excellent. Okay, give me a round of applause. Okay, how about Mr. Vaughan?
Yeah, so I think Eddie and Tom earlier brought up a very good point about the first aid box. Okay. So I think my first aid box in the office has all the very funny things inside. Yeah. All the Yoko, the fly on the hand, and the Panadol and all these things. I don't know whether I don't think we have a glove inside. So what I will do is I will go back to the office, check whether the first aid box is complete. And also to share this with my company secretary and the person involved in making sure that we have everything complete in the first aid box. So, yeah.
My house first aid box doesn't have roof.
So today you learn
buy one pair.
So do you think this course is very important?
It's very useful.
Very useful, right? So how about Mr. Tom? What do you learn?
What I learned is that you can actually apply first aid. Someone injured or injure himself and deal with a lot of this time. So what I learned today are reminders that when there's an injury or accident at both sites, I can actually go in, apply to this and then render any help that I can and deal with a lot of this arrive as an ambulance or police arrive.
Excellent answer. Okay, just to short brief what he's saying. If there is any injury, he will do the first aid first until the ambulance come in, and he will share to his colleagues what it happened to me. Okay, that is it. He will be applied. How about Eddie?
I think my places, for example, there's a few high bookshelves. So in order to reach it, you have to climb the ladder. So maybe there's a high possibility that people can fall from it. So what we can do is to educate the people who are using the ladder, go back, teach them how to do the
handsling. So can you remember what are the three steps to do sling?
For climbing, number one, you have to hold your arm up.
Hold the arm, okay.
Near the chest.
Yeah,
after
chest.
That, use the bandage and over,
mm-hmm.
And third step is to tie the knot.
Tie the knot, okay. Is it the guy?
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, so today we have learned different type of bandages, and one more thing we have learned very important is first aid box, very important what the item must be inside in place. Okay? Any other question you have?
Can we go for tea break
yes.
now?
Yeah.
I'm so hungry. I think we should go.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. 24 minutes.
That's
why. Just now, actually, I was keeping that.